Good morning. Today is the 24th day of the month of June in this 2022nd year of our Lord. It's a lovely day today. Again, blue skies, clear, a little breeze going. Just a wonderful day to be alive and well. And I hope you are wherever you are. Today, we begin in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. From Matthew's Gospel in the 13th chapter. Another parable he put before them, saying, "The kingdom of heaven is like a grain of mustard seed, which a man took and sowed in his field. It is the smallest of all seeds, but when it has grown, it is the greatest of shrubs and becomes a tree, so that the birds of the air come and make nests in its branches." And he told him another parable. "The kingdom of heaven is like leaven, which a woman took and hid in 3 measures of flour, till it was all leavened." All this Jesus said to the crowd in parables. Indeed, he said nothing to them without a parable. This was to fulfill what was spoken by the prophet, "I will open my mouth in parables, and I will utter what has been hidden since the foundation of the world." The Gospel of our Lord Jesus. Austin Farrer, who lived between 1904 and 1968, writes the following. "It is one of the most emphatic and most difficult points of Christ's own teaching that believing prayer will remove mountains. Our first reaction to such a text is to say, believing prayer, yes, but of course, one has to believe. If I had heroic faith, if I could sweat conviction from every pore, but that, anyhow, is not the teaching of Christ. I find nothing there about heroic faith, that is, his part, not ours. All he asks of us is something which genuinely joins on to his heroic faith. Even the least bit, faith, even as a grain of mustard seed, will allow a foothold in us to the force of omnipotence for removing the mountain from our path. Faith, even as a grain of mustard seed, will give irresistible force to our prayer. And yet, it would seem, many men who think they have faith, for example, the disciples of Jesus whom he was addressing in these words, have not this grain of true belief when they pray, for their prayer lacks effect. I don't find it all that Christ asks us to lash ourselves up into a fine frenzy of faith. Faith is above all things serene, not agitated, not violent. What he requires is that our faith, though there be but a grain of it, should be genuine and simple. It comes down to this, that when we pray, we should mean what we say. If we invoke God as Father, we are not asking that God should concern himself with certain limited troubles of our own, but that loving concern should take effect without any limits. We cannot pray, "I ask your heavenly love to take effect on me, but I do not want it to take effect through me on those to whom you have given me." That prayer is unprayable. And then so is this, "I want your compassion to take me as I am, but I don't want that peace of your compassion, which you have placed in me, to take others as they are, just as I am, without one plea, but not just as they are, not with any number of pleas." And that's from a faith of our own. And let us pray. And this prayer comes from Joseph Newton. Our Father, each day is a little life. Each night a tiny death. Help us to live with faith and hope and love. Lift our duty above drudgery. Let not our strength fail or the vision fade in the heat and the burden of the day. O God, make us patient and pitiful one with another in the feet and jar of life, in the fret and jar of life, remembering that each fights a hard fight and walks a lonely way. Forgive us, O Lord, if we hurt our fellow souls. Teach us a gentler tone, a sweeter charity of words, and a more healing touch. Sustain us, O God, when we must face sorrow. Give us courage for the day and hope for the morrow. Day unto day, may we lay hold of thy hand and look up into thy face. Whatever befall, until our work is finished and the day is done, in his name we pray, as Christ has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine on you, to be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you his peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord this day and forevermore. Amen.